Hi everyone, I'm here with Claire Somers, very successful businesswoman, entrepreneur, has good taste in fashion, and owns the Fashion Bomb Daily blog.
How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
Oh my God, it's my pleasure. I am from Angola, and back home, what I see the most lately is actually people from my generation and people probably from the next generation struggling on building their own businesses. And it's been a huge hustle. I feel like everyone is struggling. So I decided, you know, to talk to a few people that I consider successful and very good at what they do. I saw that you started Fashion Bomb Daily in 2006.
Yes.
Correct?
That's correct.
And was that because you were unhappy with the job that you had at that time?
That was exactly it.
Why were you unhappy?
Well, through my youth and through different internships that I had done in journalism, I found that I had this love for fashion writing. But I was in a job that wasn't the perfect job. Okay. It was perfectly imperfect in that I had a lot of free time to kind of do what I wanted to do, but I was also bored. And I was working at a magazine and they did have a fashion department, but for whatever reason, maybe I didn't have the right look, maybe I wasn't talking to the right people, for whatever reason, I couldn't get into the fashion department. And so I started applying to different magazines. I heard no after no after no. I got extremely frustrated because I was just thinking, I'm like, I graduated from Harvard with honors, and I'm just like, I can do it. You know, I was like, I have no idea why they keep telling me no. I didn't understand it. And so that frustration led to me creating a blog, and started off as a hobby, a resume builder, and it became a job because all the magazines started transitioning to online. We had this great following. We had millions of people visiting, and then we started to attract advertisers, and so eventually it became my full-time job.
During this journey, you decided to move to Paris, correct?
Yes. Yeah.
To work for
Paris Vogue.
Paris Vogue. How was that?
Yeah, so I quit my job. Eventually, I had had enough, and my mantra is life is too short to wake up every day and not be doing something that you love. And I'm the type of person who, if I'm unhappy, if I don't feel right, if I keep trying and trying and it doesn't work, then I shift, and I'm okay with that. But basically, I moved to Paris with the goal of working in fashion. We all know Paris is one of the historical homes of style, and initially I was like, I'll intern anywhere, I'll pick up pins off the floor of the Margiela Atelier, I'll do anything. But of course, I found myself back in journalism, and so I applied to the International Herald Tribune because they had a Paris bureau, but their paper is in English. And I applied to Women's Wear Daily, and I applied to Paris Vogue, and it took me a year and a half, and literally I had a cover of Paris Vogue on my wall in front of my computer that I looked at every single day.
How did you get in?
So
after applying, were you home, like waiting for them to reach out to you?
Well, no, honestly, when I was in Paris for that year and a half, I taught English. I taught English at schools. I taught English to businessmen through different programs.
But you were trying many different ways?
That's what I had to do to make money.
Exactly.
But I also had a lot of free time to blog. So okay. I say that Fashion Bomb Daily truly started to blow up when I was in Paris because I had a lot of free time.
How many people do you have on your team today?
Now we have 15.
15 people?
Yeah.
And you hired all these people?
Yeah, it's mostly freelancers. Mm-hmm. We have people who run our social media. We have people who write on the website. We have graphic designers, videographers, photographers, event planners.
You also do motivational speaking?
Yeah, I speak. Oh. I just gave a keynote last weekend. I'm speaking tomorrow at a panel.
Today you're speaking with me.
Today I'm speaking with you. Because I think a lot of women, especially women of color, they're finding that they're not getting the opportunities extended to them in their corporate jobs, and they have these passions or they want to do a certain thing, but they don't know how to do it. And so I'm like, just do it. You know, if you feel it in your heart, then work towards it. Nothing is going to be perfect. I have to keep telling myself this every day because it's easy to get scared. It's easy to stay where things are comfortable.
Yeah, especially in a world with so much competition.
Yeah.
In this field.
There's a lot of competition. Yeah, I was actually speaking to one of my designers today. So we launched fashionbombdailyshop.com as well.
Congratulations.
Thank you. It's an e-commerce platform and a lot of our designers are women and women of color. But she was like saying other people were copying her and I was like, girl, you are iconic. Don't look to the left and to the right. That's going to slow you down. You just stay focused. You have to focus on what you want to do and continuing to be creative and distinguishing yourself from other people.
What do you know today that you wish you knew when you were starting your business?
Yeah, there's the business of fashion and then there's fashion. So a lot of us were creative, so we can take a great picture, we can write a great article, or we can style a great look, but then it's about
how do you
make money from it. Especially in the fashion industry, you see so many beautiful things and you want to have them.
Yes.
You don't want to.
And they are not cheap.
So I think that if I would have gone back, I would have maybe had like somebody with some business acumen, because I think that I never knew what it could become. I didn't know I was gonna have my own company and have all these different people working for me. I just never envisioned that. So I would also say, just take yourself seriously from the beginning and like get the best person you can hire first is an accountant and a bookkeeper.
Managing a company, managing the money or the investment,
mm-hmm.
and your energy, all of that, all together.
Yeah. And you can't do it alone. I think a lot of people, they ask me like, how do you find the right team? And that can be hard, but it's really about trial and error and having people come in to help you, seeing what works and what doesn't. Maybe they can move on, you can hire somebody else, but just don't chase perfection. You're not gonna get it right, but if you don't start, then you never know. So start now.
I have a challenge for you.
I already told you I don't want to play with me. I already conceded the win to you, but you want to play pool.
Because I don't know how to play either. I'm like really
bad. I could play you in like Monopoly.
Yeah? Oh, I'm sure. Yes, that she would win, definitely.
But I will play pool.
Yes? Okay.
I'm not good.
Let's go. Let's do this.
Single most influential factor I would say would be commitment, consistency. I mean, I know this is more than one. Persistence, discipline, getting up every single day and doing it, no matter what. Some people who work for me, like my assistant even, she'll be like, I'm on vacation. And I'm like, oh really? You get to go on vacation. What? How wonderful. I'm like, I don't go on vacation. How are you going on vacation? But it's just like, that's fine. You do what you want. But like, I am so serious about this. And until I get to where I'm going, there are really no days off. So, well, one of my favorite books anyway is Think and Grow Rich by Dale Carnegie. And your recommendation for entrepreneurs to read? How to Be CEO by Jeffrey Fox and The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz.
What advice would you give to an upcoming entrepreneur locally and internationally?
Invest in yourself. Like, who's a better investment than you? So that means it can mean anything from investing in your hair and your makeup to investing in a class, investing in a book, investing in a consultation, investing in a conference.
Claire, thank you so much.
Thank you,
Madden. Yes, you are. And you know, you played very well.
Thank you. I won.
Yes, she did.
You see? I got two balls, or maybe one.
No, two.
I got two balls
in the ball. I couldn't get even one. So I really appreciated the fact that you came, that you actually played. You see, that's a go-getter. She was not here to play. She was like,
I was not here to play, but there's a lesson here, okay? Keep an open mind. do it sometimes even if you don't want to do it, and you might be pleasantly surprised.
There you go. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.